The field of genetic testing has changed dramatically in the last couple of years. We've moved from procedures that require needles and catheters to go into the uterus to taking a simple blood test from mom. Secondly, we've used the new technologies to be able to look at a much more broader range of genetic testing on the fetus before it's born. The evolution of genetic testing has been to go from looking for single diseases based on a family history, the age of the mother, or some other condition, to a broad-based screen that looks for many, many different diseases. One of the things that becomes important in this process is if we can do this in a non-invasive fashion, to take a blood sample from mom as opposed to doing an amniocentesis or a test called chorionic villosampling to be able to get that sample to do the testing. The key to genetic diagnosis of fetal abnormalities is having the ability to look for a broad range of disorders and also having the ability to be able to tell from the parents before they have children what they might be at risk for. So this field is changing to the point that we will be able to screen a couple to determine what their pregnancy specifically is risk for and offer a very precise test for their family. And microarray testing is a very precise kind of test that looks at very subtle changes in the DNA that occurs in what we call DNA replication. Those subtle changes are not seen by our current technology of karyotyping or chromosome studies, and they allow us to look for diseases that are known as copy number diseases, such as autism. The biggest controversy surrounding new genetic testing is the fact that we always run ahead with our diagnosis as opposed to our ability to treat the disorder. So for many of these disorders, we can make an early diagnosis before the pregnancy has progressed very far, but we don't have an option for therapy. So we can only talk to families about the option of terminating that pregnancy because of the abnormality found, or preparing them by getting them connected to the appropriate support systems. UPMC has been a leader in the diagnosis of genetic diseases for a number of years. Through its work at McGee Women's Hospital, it's looked at how we can use these DNA samples from mother's circulation to look for very precise genetic diseases. Now, the most important thing that practicing physicians need to know is that the field is changing quite rapidly and very dramatically, and that it's always quite important for them to seek out their local genetics professional to find out what's available for their patients and get completely informed and be able to give their patients all the information about the new technology.